Welcome back, Joystick Justice League, to episode 2 of JJL Live. I'm Mike Frisios. This is my new one-hour weekly news roundup podcast. And in part 3 for the next 10 minutes, I'm going to round up the best and worst of what I saw on the Microsoft Xbox front last week. So let's start with some of the good news. For all of you diehard Xbox fans who have been a little worried about the state of your console in the next-gen wars, you know, of course, if you look at statistics right now, the PS4 is still outselling the Xbox by about a 2-to-1 ratio. PS4 is currently sitting at about a 14.4 million consoles globally versus Xbox's 7.6, which has actually now overtaken the Wii U's 7.4 million consoles globally. But it is the holiday season. Smash Brothers is out. Master Chief Collection's out. Things are going to change rapidly. We're already seeing that, and especially over the last couple weeks, the Xbox One has seen a tremendous uptick in sales following the $50 price drop on many of its bundles, including the Call of Duty Advanced Warfare bundle and the bundle that comes with not only Assassin's Creed Unity, but also the critically acclaimed Assassin's Creed Black Flag from last year. And I think there's also another bundle with the Master Chief Collection. But regardless, now, including a premium AAA current game, you're getting the Xbox One, let's just say with that and Call of Duty, for $350, $50 less than the PS4, which arguably doesn't have the same clout going to the holiday season as the Xbox One does. I mean, when you really think about it, and Blake Jorgensen makes this point, you've got Sunset Overdrive, you've got Halo Master Chief Collection, plus all of these incredible third-party AAA titles that are running comparatively well to the PS4 counterpart. When you drop that $50 price tag, he sees that as giving Microsoft some incredible momentum through holiday 2014 to essentially close the generation gap by early 2015. He feels really confident that the Xbox is in fact going to catch up to the PS4 next year. And I see some truth to what he's saying. My only reservation is that the PS4's lineup of exclusives is set to explode early next year, beginning in February, with The Order 1886 and Bloodborne. So that could change again, but he does have some merit, and we do see it again in the last couple weeks. Xbox Ones are flying out the door. People want to play Master Chief Collection. Now, let's talk about the flip side of Microsoft's fortunes. Yes, things may look good theoretically going into holiday 2014, but let's look at the reality. Let's look at the crown jewel of the Xbox One, which is Master Chief Collection. Okay, fine. So Sunset Overdrive worked out well. AAAs are up and running well, but Master Chief Collection, almost 2 weeks after release, is still plagued with matchmaking problems. 343 Industries, like, obviously we know that it's the online is virtually unplayable. It's hard to get into lobbies. And 343 promised that on November 20th of last week, they were going to provide this massive update, which was supposed to fix all this. So November 20th comes and goes, and I'm paying attention to the news. And I don't really see anything on even Reddit or NeoGAF about the state of the Master Chief Collection. I'm just seeing a lot more frustration. And then this past Saturday, November 22nd, I read Forbes, and Paul Tassi, who is a big Halo fan, is going on about his ongoing frustrations with Master Chief Collection, and I had to check the date to be sure. I'm like, did you get the patch? Have you played it recently? Have you updated the game? Yes, he in fact reported that he had patched the game, and still, it was almost as if fixing certain problems created a whole plethora of new ones. And I see it through my own social media that people are still complaining. Apparently they've added the rumble mode to Halo 2, but a lot of the issues that were there still haven't been resolved. And this is, according to Tassi, really killing what could be good momentum on Microsoft's side. Because I'm pretty sure he saw what Jorgensen was saying about Microsoft's positive momentum. And Tassi is simply stating his fears that with all this positive uptick in sales, the crown jewel that was supposed to be the slam dunk in Microsoft's holiday calendar is not working. And fine, you know, the campaign doesn't really have any problems. There's a few things that they fixed about it. But come on. We know why people play Halo. They've already played the campaign. Yes, they'll probably play it again, but people want to play online with their friends. And the longer this goes on, and the longer they can't resolve these issues in a timely fashion, going into the holiday when especially, you know, younger people are getting off of school and they want to go home and play some Halo with their friends, my fear is that with all these other amazing games that came out over the last couple weeks, they're just going to ignore Halo eventually. They're going to get fed up. I see people already getting fed up. I mean, Boogie2988 put out a Francis video, I think, just about like a few hours ago, doing the typical Francis thing about fuming about how Halo still isn't working. I mean, this is the flagship title for the Xbox One. And if they couldn't get this right, geez, like what, like, can we expect anything from Halo 5? I mean, already the people who have had access to the Halo 5 beta are not that impressed. I mentioned this last week that Ryan McCaffrey said that it didn't feel right. It felt very early, very unpolished. And I mean, and that's to be expected. I mean, they are revealing this beta a year ahead of time. And even Bonnie Ross, head of 343 Industries, says that they have a long-term plan for the series and that they are unveiling this beta early to get feedback ahead of time so they can make Halo 5 and then eventually Halo 6 the best possible experience it can be. That's all we can expect. That's why people buy Xboxes over PlayStations, so they can get Master Chief. But 2 weeks into this, And that's the thing, it's not just a bunch of nerds complaining on Reddit about problems with Master Chief. This is Forbes magazine complaining about what was supposed to be a no-brainer. And again, when people are at that 0 hour trying to figure out what gifts to buy their loved ones, their gaming loved ones, are they going to go for Halo Master Chief Collection knowing how problematic it is, knowing that the people who created the franchise, Bungie, are now doing Destiny, already that they've already farmed it off to somebody else, that they're not even proving themselves anymore. It's sad to see, and I'm going to be paying attention to the news this week, keeping updated on Master Chief Collection, because the other problem that what we talked about last week, the new esports league that 343 is trying to head up, which is called the Halo Championship Series, had to be delayed because of the multiplayer problem. So originally, the first preseason online cup was scheduled for November 16th. It got pushed up to yesterday, November 23rd, and I haven't seen a single article or reaction yet. Maybe something will be out by the time I get this video up and we can talk about it this coming weekend. But at this point, wow, they're in like, I'd say that 343 and Microsoft are heading into similar territory that EA was in with the botched launches of SimCity and Battlefield 4. I don't want to get into fear-mongering because Halo is massive. It's not your regular video game. And the love that people have for Halo is going to transcend a bunch of first month launch window glitches that I know are going to get fixed over time. And I don't think it's going to have quite the alienating effect that I think Tassi feels that it's going to have. But he has a point, and Eric Kane made this as well, that when a game is getting slaughtered critically for game-breaking issues, and then when you contrast that against other games, similar games like, say, Far Cry 4, which has got an over 85 Metacritic score, when you have to pick between one or the other, which one are you going to buy for your kid to make sure they're not disappointed Christmas morning? You're going to get the plague-ridden Master Chief Collection, or the tight and polished Far Cry 4, or Destiny, or any other competitor that is working and functioning properly. So, something I'm going to be keeping track of over the course of the week and talking more about on the weekend. Hopefully, there'll be some good news for the state of that game. Wow, we've got about another minute for Microsoft news here, so I just want to quickly talk about Ori and the Blind Forest, which is one of those indie, which is kind of the crown jewel in the indie side of the Xbox library. This game, when it was revealed at E3, has been getting tremendous buzz. It's essentially like this hand-drawn Metroidvania kind of platformer with light RPG elements, and it's very epic in scope. It has that kind of epic Disney feel to it in terms of like the graphics, the incredible epic sound design. but it got delayed. So it's not coming out this holiday season, but that's not a big deal. This is actually probably a good delay. They said they're going to be putting more polish on it. So just in case you were expecting that you might see a late November or early December release for Ori and the Blind Forest, unfortunately, you're probably going to have to wait more until January, February, but that can't be a bad thing. It's only for polish. So that's Microsoft news. We'll be coming back in a bit. Oh, one more thing before I leave too, is that if you are into retro gaming, sorry, I just have to add this one little bit before I go to commercial break. If you're into retro gaming and you want to kind of see what the struggling Microsoft Television Studios is up to, one of their first projects, which is Atari Game Over, is available free now on your 360, Xbox One, and even on the PC. So you can actually see a documentary about the recent New Mexico excavation for the buried Atari 2600 cartridges of E.T. the Extraterrestrial. So you can see that free on your Xbox right now. It's available, as is the long-awaited HBO Go app, which is now on Xbox One, so you can get your Boardwalk Empire and all that fun stuff on. So Mike Frusios for Joystick Justice League. Stay tuned for Nintendo news in part 4 coming up next.